Thank you, Brian, and good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
We all have Palm Sunday. That doesn't mean Lent and an end exactly, but we're entering the kind of the final stretch as we remember the last week of Jesus' life. Holy Week, as it is often called, is best experienced as a journey with Jesus. And so as many events, services are able to kind of manage this time on this week, the more effect, if you like, the more power Easter has for you at the end of it. So do please consider what you can do. I won't go through the whole list of everything that's going to happen this week, because it's quite a lot, but they are all in the bulletin sheet. Just highlight a couple. Thursday evening, remembering the Last Supper, we have a joint service at 7:30 at Summerbridge Methodist Church. It's a bit later than usual, because the idea is the service ends in darkness, as you remember Jesus' arrest. And then Good Friday, we have the Walk of Witness, or kind of a sort of Stations of the Cross event, in Papybridge High Street, with the silver band, so hymns, reflections, readings, starting outside St. Cuthbert's Church, and we kind of come down the high street with the band. So that's well worth coming to at 11 o'clock on Friday. So far, so good as far as the forecast is concerned. A more reflective event is 2 o'clock, an hour before the cross, at Holy Trinity Church on Good Friday. Throughout the week, up in Holy Trinity, I've put up some Stations of the Cross, artwork images of Jesus' journey from his condemnation to the end. That's a powerful thing if you're able to just take a bit of time this week to go through. There are some poems and reflections up with each image, if you wanted to use those as well. And you can either do it all in one go, or sort of in a few bits throughout the week. But however you want to make this journey of Holy Week, or are able to, let's consider journeying with Christ this week. As Thomas said to him, said to his disciples when Jesus set his face to Jerusalem, and the other disciples were concerned, he said, "Let's go and die with him." As it turned out, they weren't able to do that, but they were able to share his journey with him, and then of course Easter at the end of it. We're going to keep a brief moment of quiet before we begin the service. The service takes a different pattern on Palm Sunday. There's no sermon, but there is a full reading of the Passion story from one of the Gospels this year, from St. Matthew's Gospel. But to break it up, we've broken it up into different voices, which will be performed is a bit of a grand word for it, to be done for us, and there won't be a sermon after that. We'll just leave a space of quiet to reflect after that, to let it tell its own story, really. And also the service begins slightly differently in terms of, you'll see. We'll follow it through in the order of service. Let's just keep a moment of quiet prayer before we begin. Hosanna to the Son of David, the King of Israel. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Dear friends in Christ, during Lent, we have been preparing by works of love and self-sacrifice for the celebration of our Lord's death and resurrection. Today we come together to begin this solemn celebration in union with the Church throughout the world. Christ enters his own city to complete his work as our Saviour, to suffer, to die, and to rise again. Let us go with him in faith and love, so that united with him in his sufferings, we may share his risen life. So let us pray. God, our Saviour, whose Son, Jesus Christ, entered Jerusalem as Messiah to suffer and to die, let these palms that we have with us, these palm crosses, perhaps we'd like to hold them. Lord, let these palms be for us signs of his victory, and grant that we who bear them in his name may ever hail him as our King and follow him in the way that leads to eternal life, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Let's stand for the Palm Gospel, as it's called here. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When they had come near to Jerusalem, and had reached Bethphage at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied and a colt with her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, just say this, 'The Lord needs them,' and he will send them immediately." This took place to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet, saying, "Tell the daughter of Zion, look, your king is coming to you, humble and mounted on a donkey, and on the colt, the foal of a donkey." The disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and put their cloaks on them, and he sat on them. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds that went ahead of him and that followed were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heaven." When he entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, asking, "Who is this?" The crowds were saying, "This is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Now we're going to sing our first song, which is on the extra sheets you have. Make way for Christ the King. If anyone wants to wave a palm, either this one or one of these bigger ones, these are not mammoth's teeth. These are palm branches that haven't quite splayed out yet. If anyone wants to have a go, please do grab one. Just be careful you don't whack anybody with it. Let's celebrate. As the people did, as they welcomed Jesus into Jerusalem.
Thank you.
Please be seated. Almighty and everlasting God, who in your tender love towards the human race sent your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, to take upon him our flesh, to suffer death upon the cross. Grant that we may follow the example of his patience and humility, and also be partakers of his resurrection through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Just one short reading before we have another hymn. This was written around about 600 years before the events by the prophet Zechariah. Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout aloud, O daughter of Jerusalem. Lo, your king comes to you. Triumphant and victorious is he, humble and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. He will cut off the chariot from Ephraim, and the war horse from Jerusalem, and the battle bow shall be cut off, and he shall command peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. As for you also, because of the blood of my covenant with you, I will set your prisoners free from the waterless pit. Return to your stronghold, O prisoners of hope. Today I declare that I will restore to you double. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We'll stand and sing again a more traditional hymn this time in the red hymn books, number 61, Ride On, Ride On. Majesty. Here, the passion our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew.
When Jesus had finished all these sayings, he said to his disciples,
"You know that after 2 days the Passover is come, and the Son of Man will be delivered up to be crucified."
And then the chief priests and the elders of the people gathered in the palace of the high priest, who is called Caiaphas, and took counsel together in order to arrest Jesus by stealth and kill him. But they said,
"Not during the feast, lest there be a tumult among the people."
Now when Jesus was at Bethany, in the house of Simon the leper, a woman came up to him with an alabaster jar of very expensive ointment, and she poured it on his head as he sat at the table. But when the disciples saw it, they were indignant.
"Why this waste? The ointment might have been sold for a large sum and given to the poor."
But Jesus, aware of this, said to them,
"Why do you trouble this woman? She has done a beautiful thing for me. For you always have the poor with you, but you will not always have me. In pouring this ointment on my body, she has done it to prepare me for burial. Truly, I say to you, wherever this gospel is preached in the whole world, what she has done will be told in memory of her."
Then one of the 12, who was called Judas Iscariot, went to the chief priests and said,
"What will you give if I deliver Jesus to you?"
And they paid him 30 pieces of silver, and from that moment he sought an opportunity to betray him. Now on the first day of unleavened bread, the disciples came to Jesus.
"Well, you have us prepared for the Passover."
"Go into the city to a certain one and say to him, 'The teacher says, my time is at hand. I will keep the Passover at your house with my disciples.'"
And the disciples did as Jesus had directed them, and they prepared the Passover. When it was evening, he sat at table with the 12 disciples, and as they were eating, he said,
"Truly I say to you, one of you will betray me."
And they were very sorrowful, and began to say to him one after another,
"He who has dipped his hand in the dish with me will betray me. The Son of Man goes as it is written of him. But woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that man if he had not been born."
Judas, who betrayed him, said,
"Is it I, Master?"
"You have said so."
Now as they were eating, Jesus took bread and blessed and broke it, and gave it to the disciples and said,
"Take, eat, this is my body."
And he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying,
"Drink of it, all of you, for this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, I shall not drink again of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom."
When they had sung a hymn, Jesus and the disciples went out to the Mount of Olives. Then Jesus said to them,
"You will all fall away because of me this night. For it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered.' But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee."
Peter declared to him,
"Will they all fall away because of you? I will never fall away."
"Truly I say to you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times.
Even if I was to die with you,
And so did all the disciples. Then Jesus went with them to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples,
"Sit here while I go yonder and pray."
And taking them with him, Peter and the 2 sons of Zebedee, he began to be sorrowful and troubled. Then he said to them,
"My soul is very sorrowful, even to death. Remain here and watch with me."
And going a little farther, he fell on his face and he prayed,
"My Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will.
And he came to the disciples and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter,
So could you not watch with me 1 hour? Watch and pray that you may not enter into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak.
Again, for the second time, he went away and prayed.
My Father, if this cannot pass unless I drink it, your will be done.
And again he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were heavy. So leaving them again, he went away and prayed for the third time, saying the same words. Then he came to the disciples and said to them,
Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? Behold, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand.
While he was still speaking, Judas came, one of the 12, and with him a great crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had given them a sign.
The one I shall kiss is the man. Seize him.
And he came up to Jesus at once.
Hail, Master.
And he kissed him.
Friend, why are you here?
Then they came up and laid hands on Jesus and seized him. And behold, one of those who were with Jesus stretched out his hand and drew his sword and struck the slave of the high priest and cut off his ear.
Put your sword back into its place. For all who take the sword will perish by the sword. Do you think that I cannot appeal to my Father, and he will at once send me more than 12 legions of angels? But how then should the scriptures be fulfilled, that this must be so?
At that hour, Jesus said to the crowds,
Have you come out as against a robber, with swords and clubs to capture me? Day after day I sat in the temple teaching, and you did not seize me. But all this has taken place that the scriptures of the prophets might be fulfilled.
Then all the disciples forsook him and fled. Then those who'd seized Jesus led him to Caiaphas, the high priest, where the scribes and the elders had gathered. But Peter followed him at a distance, as far as the courtyard of the high priest, and going inside, he sat with the guards to see the end. Now the chief priests and the whole council sought false testimony against Jesus, that they might put him to death. But they found none, though many false witnesses came forward. At last, two came forward.
This fellow said, I am able to destroy the temple of God and to build it in 3 days.
And the high priest stood up and said,
Have you no answer to make? What is it that these men testify against you?
But Jesus was silent.
I adjure you by the living God, tell us if you are the Christ, the Son of God.
You have said so. But I tell you, hereafter you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power and coming on the clouds of heaven.
Then the high priest tore his robes and said,
He has uttered blasphemy. Why do we still need witnesses? You have now heard his blasphemy. What is your judgment?
He deserves death.
Then they spat in his face and struck him, and some slapped him.
Prophesy to us, Christ, as he will struck you.
Now Peter was sitting outside in the courtyard, and a maid came up to him and said,
You also were with Jesus the Galilean.
But he denied it before them all.
Do you not know what you mean?
And when he went out to the porch, another maid saw him, and she said to the bystanders,
This man was with Jesus of Nazareth.
And again he denied it with an oath. And after a little while, the bystanders came up and said to Peter,
Certainly, you are also one of them, for your accent betrays you.
Then he began to invoke a curse on himself and to swear.
I do not know the man.
And immediately the cock crowed, and Peter, remembering the saying of Jesus, Before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times, and he went out and wept bitterly. When morning came, all the chief priests and the elders of the people took counsel against Jesus to put him to death, and they bound him and led him away and delivered him to Pilate, the governor. When Jesus, his betrayer, saw that he was condemned, he repented and brought back the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priests and elders.
I have sinned in betraying innocent blood.
What is that to us? See to it yourself.
And throwing down the piece of the silver in the temple, he departed, and he went and hanged himself. But the chief priest, taking the pieces of silver, said,
it is not lawful to put them into the treasury, since they are blood money.
So they took counsel and bought with them the potter's field to bury strangers in. Therefore that field has been called the field of blood to this day. Then was fulfilled what had been spoken by the prophet Jeremiah, saying, and they took the 30 pieces of silver, the price of him on whom a price had been set by some of the sons of Israel, and they gave them for the potter's field, as the Lord directed me. Now Jesus stood before the governor, and the governor asked him,
are you the king of the Jews?
You have said so.
But when he was accused by the chief priests and elders, he made no answer. And then Pilate said to him,
do you not hear how many things they testify against us?
But he gave him no answer, not even to a single charge, so that the governor wondered greatly. Now at the feast, the governor was accustomed to release to the crowd any one prisoner whom they wanted. And they had then a notorious prisoner called Barabbas. So when they had gathered, Pilate said to them,
whom do you want me to release for you, Barabbas or Jesus, who is called Christ?
For he knew that it was out of envy that they had delivered him up. Besides, whilst he was sitting on the judgment seat, his wife sent word to him,
have nothing to do with that righteous man, for I have suffered much over him today in a dream.
Now the chief priests and the elders persuaded the people to ask for Barabbas and destroy Jesus. The governor said to them,
which of the two do you want me to release for you?
Barabbas.
Then what shall I do with Jesus, who is called Christ?
Let him be crucified.
Why? What evil has he done?
Let him be crucified.
So when Pilate saw that he was gaining nothing, but rather that a riot was beginning, he took water and washed his hands before the crowd.
I am innocent of this man's blood. See to it yourselves.
His blood be on us and our children.
Then Pilate released for them Barabbas, and having scourged Jesus, delivered him to be crucified. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the praetorium, and they gathered the whole battalion before him, and they stripped him, and put a scarlet robe upon him, and placing a crown of thorns, they put it on his head, and put a reed in his right hand. And kneeling before him, they mocked him.
Hail, King of the Jews!
And they spat on him, and took the reed and struck him on the head. And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the robe, and put his own clothes on him, and led him away to crucify him. As they were marching out, they came upon a man of Cyrene, Simon by name. This man they compelled to carry his cross. And when they came to a place called Golgotha, which means place of the skull, they offered him wine to drink, mingled with gall. But when he tasted it, he would not drink it. And when they had crucified him, they divided his garments amongst them by casting lots. Then they sat down and kept watch over him there. And over his head they put the charge against him, which read, this is Jesus, King of the Jews. Then two robbers were crucified with him, one on the right and one on the left. And those who passed by derided him, wagging their heads.
You who will destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself. If you are the Son of God, come down from the cross.
So also the chief priests with the scribes and elders mocked him.
He saved others. He cannot save himself. He is the King of Israel. Let him come down now from the cross, and we will believe him. He trusts in God. Let God deliver him now, if he desires him. For he said, I am the Son of God.
And the robbers who were crucified with him also reviled him in the same way. Now from the sixth hour there was darkness over all the land until the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice,
Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani.
That is, my God, why have you forsaken me? And some of the bystanders hearing it said,
This man is calling Elijah.
And one of them at once ran and took a sponge, filled it with vinegar, put it on a reed and gave it to him to drink. But the others said,
Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to save him.
And Jesus cried again with a loud voice and yielded up his spirit. And behold, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom, and the earth shook and the rocks were split. The tombs also were opened, and many bodies of the saints who'd fallen asleep were raised, and coming out of the tombs after his resurrection, they went into the Holy Spirit and city and appeared to many. When the centurion and those who were with him, keeping watch over Jesus, saw the earthquake and what took place, they were filled with awe and said,
Truly, this man was the Son of God.
There were also many women there, looking on from afar, who had followed Jesus from Galilee, ministering to him, among whom were Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mother of James and Joseph, and the mother of the sons of Zebedee. When it was evening, there came a rich man from Arimathea called Joseph, who was also a disciple of Jesus. He went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. When Pilate ordered it to be given to him, and Joseph took the body and wrapped it in a clean linen shroud and laid it in his own tomb, which he had hewn in the rock. And he rolled a great stone into the door of the tomb and departed. Mary Magdalene and the other Mary were there, sitting opposite the sepulchre. Next day, that is, after the day of preparation, the chief priests and the Pharisees gathered before Pilate and said,
Sir, you remember how that impostor said, while he was still alive, After 3 days I will rise again. Therefore order the sepulchre to be made secure until the third day. Let his disciples go and seal him away, and tell the people he has risen from the dead, and the last fraud will be worse than the first.
You have a guard of soldiers, so make it as secure as you can.
So they went and made the sepulchre secure by sealing the stone and setting a guard.
This is the passion of praise to you, Lord Christ. Let's reflect on that for a moment or two. Let us pray. We stand with Christ in his suffering for forgiveness for the many times we have denied Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For grace to seek out those habits of sin which mean spiritual death, and by prayer and self-discipline to overcome them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Christian people, that through the suffering of disunity there may grow a rich union in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who make laws, interpret them and administer them, that our common life may be ordered in justice and mercy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who still make Jerusalem a battleground, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who have the courage and honesty to work openly for justice and peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those in the darkness and agony of isolation, that they may find support and encouragement, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who, weighed down with hardship, failure or sorrow, feel that God is far from them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who are tempted to give up the way of the cross, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we, with those who have died in faith, may find mercy in the day of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Holy God, holy and strong, holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Amen.
So let's stand for the peace. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share in his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you. Let
us offer another a sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you. Next hymn is quite a long one, but it is also a reflective one as we approach to receive all that Jesus did for us in that first Holy Week. As we remember his death and resurrection and receive it, let's prepare for that as we sing number 63, My Song is Love Unto.
Love will show up.
our hearts.
You give them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For at this time, at the time of his passion and resurrection, for as the time of his passion and resurrection draws near, the whole world is called to acknowledge his hidden majesty. The power of the life-giving cross reveals the judgment that has come upon the world and the triumph of Christ crucified. He is the victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever, our advocate in heaven to plead our cause, exalting us there to join with angels and archangels, forever praising you and saying, Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood. Who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave thanks. He broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself, made once for all upon the cross. Proclaiming his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, we look for the coming of your kingdom, and with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in your glory.
Accept through him, our great High Priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts, in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise.
Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen.
As our Saviour, Jesus Christ, has taught, let us pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the
power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share one body.
Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy upon us.
Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy upon us.
Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace.
Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to this supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
We do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table. But you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your glorious Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood. That we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Jesus Christ, you humbled yourself in taking the form of a servant, and in obedience died on the cross for our salvation. Give us the mind to follow you and to proclaim you as Lord and King to the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us with your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, you declared your love. Gave us grace and opened the gates of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free. And the whole earth live to praise your name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our final hymn is number 250 in the Red Books. Thou didst leave thy throne, including the refrain, come to my heart, Lord Jesus, there is room in my heart for thee. On earth, you didn't find room for him, or they didn't find room for him in Holy Week. Indeed, they threw him out. Let's welcome him to our hearts. Let's stand to sing. Also, Good Friday, things are advertised on there, a simple sort of going, come with me. It's often quite powerful, but Easter's one of those times when people might just be a little bit more open. So do take one of those away and think about using it. You could also take them the palm cross that isn't left. I think there may be a few. May Christ crucified draw you to himself, to find in him a sure ground for faith, a firm support for hope, and the assurance of sins forgiven. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you, and remain